So Travel Triangle is a holidays marketplace where we strive to connect potential travelers to multiple travel agents to help a potential traveler, you know, plan, book and customize the holiday of their choice. So one of the, you know, biggest challenges that we face to grow the platform is how do we keep our vendor base engaged and how do we keep improving their performance on the platform. That means a travel agent is interacting with more and more travelers, is you know, working on the platform for a longer period of time, and is engaged you know, to do all of these things. Yeah, so the lead up to this gamification project was a very small, you know, I would say tip of the iceberg sort of experiment that we did with the basic points, badges and leadership module. So we started giving reward points to our travel agents for the actions that we wanted them to do on the platform. And that sort of, you know, helped us in immensely improving their engagement on the platform, right? So this gave us the idea of, you know, why don't we delve deeper into the gamification module, because from what we understood, PBL or points badge leadership system is just the tip of the iceberg there. And that's when we decided to, you know, use gamification or game thinking approach more to help solve the engagement problem of vendors on our platform. Some of the experiments that we have done in the past definitely improve our travel agent experience and engagement on the platform. But after some time, let's say 3 months, 5 months, that particular intervention becomes a business as usual process and loses the sheen, right? The habit loop technique that, you know, we deployed in the game while doing this project around game thinking. So this technique helped us understand, you know, what are the different habits or process loops which our agents undertake in a normal daily life when they work on the platform, and which of all of those habits or process loops are relevant to the Travel Triangle platform, which can help boost the performance engagement of those vendors. Then there's another technique that we use, which you know, I personally named it as rapid prototyping approach, which basically, you know, helped us test an hypothesis by developing a prototype and getting real-time user feedback within just a matter of days. Now we are able to test a hypothesis, get user feedback and iterate on our solution within a matter of, you know, 3 to 4 days, which earlier used to take us around 15 to 20 days. So that is a massive improvement in terms of how fast are we able to iterate on our problem and solution statements. Another area that, you know, game thinking approach exposed us to was something called superfans. Now, basically, the concept of superfans basically tells us which are those users or travel agents in our case, which can be very proactive in giving us feedback on new initiatives or new experiments that we are trying to, you know, work on. This also helped us, you know, reduce our experimentation cycle to a great extent. In fact, I think in a matter of 2 to 3 weeks only, we have been able to launch 3 to 4 key big features that our travel agents are loving. And, you know, even from their usability matrices, we are able to sort of predict that their engagement on the platform has increased a lot. The responses that we have received from our travel agents is immensely positive in terms of solving their daily challenges that they face when they, you know, use our platform. So their likability for the Travel Triangle platform has improved within a matter of 2 to 3 weeks. As I mentioned, the habit loop technique has helped us identify which are those core processes that we need to focus on. And now what we are trying to do is, you know, design our entire product roadmap around how do we improve those core processes. The rapid experimentation approach is something that we are trying to build in our DNA now. If we are able to shorten the experimentation cycle from, you know, 15 to 20 days to 3 to 4 days, that is an immense, immense improvement. The project has also enabled us to improve how we work in a longer term. And that is what we are now focusing on.
When we started talking to Travel Triangle, their focus was on gamification. And I remember you were the one who suggested that, you know, even if it is gamification that we want to do, use game thinking as the steps to get there, to an effective implementation. Why you wanted to go that route?
Yeah. So for my experience in doing gamification for a couple of years, I look at actually the objective that Travel Triangle they want to achieve is very different. They are looking into a long-term engagement, driving behavior and habits. Normally, when we focus on gamification, if you only talk about the points, badges, leaderboard, it's very shallow. So whatever that they have experiment, that's great. But I look at for long-term engagement, we really need to look at actually what really people care about and things in game thinking process like learning loop, building the habit.
What has been your experience in interviews with superfans, Jaxton? That seems to be like a great experience.
Before we talk about the experience of the interview, I think that actually we did very well and we did the superfan screening to dig into the motivations behind whatever that they are doing, the purpose. That interview was really awesome. I mean, the unpack of the findings, insights are so meaningful for us.